Welcome back. So as an added bonus, I'll be converting the project to B4J, which is for desktop or PC. We did that for iOS. When you check the previous video, you will see it. So let's do that. For conversion to other platforms, we have to take four major steps. The first one is you add the necessary libraries. The second one is you import the modules to the new project. Then you can copy the layout file as well, and then finally you do your conditional compilation by giving the directive for the specific project or a platform you are working on. I'll open the B4A and then the B4J app. So we have our B4A here. Let's go to the libraries tab, then add the same libraries to B4J. Okay. So now that we've added all the necessary libraries used for the project, we go to step 2, which is importing the modules. Always make sure you link it so that the code will be shared between the platforms. Good. The next step is copying the layout. So I'll open the designer for both projects. Okay, so we've copied all the three layouts, so we can close the B4A and concentrate on the B4J. Now the next step is fixing any errors and using conditional compilation directives. Let's check our logs for errors. First things first, we've not declared SQL, which we did in the project main, the main module, so we'll do that. Now with B4J, since the database you're using is SQLite, you have to declare it as SQLite database and initialize it as same. And the SQLite depends on SQLite JDBC. So if you don't have it, if you don't have the JAR file in your additional database, kindly search the forum. You see a link to download the SQLite JDBC JAR file. Then you put it in the additional database. So I'll add my own to the main module. I'll add it under the project attribute. For B4J, when you check, we have to first set the data folder before you can use default folder. So we'll do that in the create side. Let's name it membership. Good. Then on our first tab, we don't have the database, that's why it's highlighted. So we sync the file using the comment link here. Control click to sync the files. Okay, now for the initialization for the database SQL Lite in B4J, we use the conditional compilation again. If B4A, if B4J, right? Can initialize SQLite database location, database name, let's add true. So if before J that else. If that else means for B for A and B for I, then they will use this side. Let's check the log for another error. I think that is that. Let's I'm getting a splash thing is not used. Yeah, let's check the main page. Make sure that image is added to the image view file. Image view. Okay. Now let's find our project. There we go. So let's add new. Okay, back isn't working. I think with B4J the button it's a mouse click, not click, so you have to also fix that. So I'll close and go to the add layout. We can also change the color and things to blue like the way we did for the B4I. So as you can see, label doesn't have click event, the mouse click event. We have the mouse click. We can also, as a trick I use, I can just bring this to here. So if B for J, then we'll use this. Then hashtag else. So else, we use this one. I hope this is clear. So they'll both use this NSAP. So depending on the platform, this for B4J NSAP or this for B for A and I and NSAP, and they'll both use the code here. So save. And let's run project 1 second. Nice one. Delete Paul Jones. Search Paul. Okay. Thank you for watching and stay tuned. Please subscribe and turn on the notification. Bye.